We are conducting a webinar for charity. I am happy to announce that more than 5,000 people have already registered. And we have room to take another 5,000 people. If you have not registered, click on the link in the description. And if you want to know more details about the webinar, you can check this video. Hi. This is P.R. Sundar. Many people ask me to make a video about a Franklin Templeton issue. I am going to tell you something you know and something nobody knows about this issue. But before going to the Templeton issue, let me tell you something else. In stock market, generally there are two types of people: option buyers and option sellers. Option buyers are mostly retail people, very small people, and play with a small amount of money. But generally, option sellers are ultra HNI people and play with crores of rupees. I have already stated many times, option sellers have a very big advantage. While selling the option, they have to pay the margin money, but that margin money they do not have to pay in cash. They can put their money in equity shares or bank FD or mutual funds, liquid funds or equity funds, and they can give those things as a collateral to the exchange, and then based on that collateral limit they can do the trading. And in fact, all the ultra HNI clients will be doing that. I know many ultra HNI clients personally, and most of them are risk averse people. They do play in options market. That is a different story, that's a different risk. But their capital, that they do not want to invest in equity market. What most of the people do, they invest the capital in debt mutual funds and then give those debt mutual fund as a collateral to the exchange, and based on the limit available, they do the trading in options market. You may be thinking, what I am talking about option buying and selling when I am talking about the Franklin Templeton issue. Now I will be connecting them both. Before that, I'll just tell you some keywords. You Google it, you will find something interesting, which is called butterfly effect in chaos theory. Just type in Google butterfly effect and chaos theory, and you will find something very interesting. Simply put it, what is happening in a small scale in a particular place will be affecting it in a big way in somewhere else on a bigger scale. What happened in the case of Franklin Templeton? They have wound up 6 different mutual funds. All of them are debt mutual funds because there were too many requests for redemption. The money that they lent to the corporates, they are not able to get the money back. So they have wound up the 6 schemes of mutual fund. Now, what does it mean, winding up? Which means, if you have already invested in that fund, now you want the money back, you cannot get the money back. Fresh, you want to invest, you cannot invest. Of course, that's not a question now because nobody wants to invest now. So, as and when the money lent to the corporates by this Franklin Templeton, as and when those people pay the money back, and they will be returning the money to you. Of course, there is a danger of default by some of the corporates. So you may not even get the full money. So that is the danger now. But you can ask, it is a question of about 30,000 crore. People have invested in debt mutual fund. Now they cannot get back their money. Only when the company gets the money from the corporates and they will distribute it. What it has got to do with the stock market? Why the stock market has to fall because of this? So that is where I told you the butterfly effect of chaos theory. What happens? Most of the ultra HNI clients would have invested their money in Franklin Templeton debt funds. They would have given those debt funds as collateral to the exchange, assuming that all the 30,000 crore has been given to the exchange as a collateral. So that means people would have taken position for about 30,000 crore. Since Franklin Templeton has wind up the scheme, in case if one HNI client default to the exchange cannot encash the collateral value. So therefore, exchange has decided the collateral value should be zero for all these six mutual funds, which means those people who have taken the position, they had to close their positions immediately because they will no longer get any limit based on this collateral. So this forced liquidation by option sellers or even people playing in futures, it has created some imbalance in the demand and supply scenario. So that was the main reason why the markets fell on Friday. So remember, whatever happens any part of the world, anywhere, the first one will be affected will be stock market. So hope you find this information useful. Thank you for watching.